This boiler has stopped working, and it's making chattering noise. It sounds like the relay inside is constantly opening and closing. First, need to shut down the boiler. This is the controller box after disassemble the case. Remove those two screws. The controller is now hung down from the front, but the rear is still hooked to the back. Add a wire to hook the controller box to the case, then unhook the back. Take a note of the wiring of this terminal block and disconnect the wires to the PCB. Remember the location of these connectors and remove them from the PCB. Take the PCB out from the controller box. This is the front view of the PCB control board. And here is the back view of the PCB control board. Because this boiler is quite old, I suspect the electrolytic capacitors inside have reached the service life. The relays cannot get a smooth power supply, so they are constantly opening and closing, and making chattering noise. There are 5 electrolytic capacitors on the control board, marked as C1, C3, C5, C7, and C13. I used a multimeter to measure the capacitance. Here are the actually measured values versus the rated values. Clearly, 3 of them are severely degraded. I replaced all 5 electrolytic capacitors with original specification. Assemble the control board back, and the boiler is now working fine. This is the system diagram of this boiler. Please note there are 2 fuses on this control board. This is the datasheet of a typical high-temperature electrolytic capacitor. As you can see, the working life is only 2,000 hours at 105 degrees Celsius, which is about 83 days. The actual working temperature is much lower than 105 degrees Celsius. So this control board has been working fine for nearly 20 years. Please leave comment below if you have any questions. Hope this video is useful to you. Please click like and subscribe to support me. Thank you.